be Hawaii's next congressional rep testing the hearts of newborns and a possible moratorium on GMOs.
Well, lots to talk about. Let's get straight to it this morning. Let's go ahead and talk to Civil Beat reporter Chad Blair. How are you doing on a Wednesday, Chad?
Good morning, Laura. Good morning, Ann. I'm doing very good. Thank you.
Good. All right, good. We got a lot to talk about then. So you got the energy. Let's talk about the crowded race to replace Congresswoman Colleen Hanabusa. I got some leaders in the pack, but still more than 5 months to go before the primary. What do you think?
Well, Donna Mercado Kim is ahead. She's got 25% of the vote, but Mark Dekai is not far behind with 20%. All the other candidates that we surveyed are back in single digits. But you know what? It is still very early. A lot of voters, more than one-third that we surveyed, said they just don't know who they're going to vote for in the CD1 race to replace Colleen Hanabusa. So the race still remains open. Any candidate has a shot at it.
Yeah, and all these candidates, a majority, I should say, meeting earlier this week.
Yeah. Exactly.
Shifting gears, let's talk about one lawmaker calling a no-brainer here. We're talking about a bill that really could help to save the lives of newborns. What's going on here?
Well, it's a test to detect congenital birth defects, and it's used in 30 other states, but not here in Hawaii. We had a bill last year to make this the law, but it did not pass. Well, Mike Gabbard in the Senate is pushing new legislation to have this examination. It's quick, it's non-invasive, and it only costs $1. And so Mike Gabbard says, you know, it's a no-brainer. This thing saves lives. So far, that legislation is alive at the session.
Let's hope it stays alive. All right, hey, I don't know how many times in the past year I've said GMOs back in the spotlight. I think every couple of weeks or so. It is, though, and this time on Maui and over this ballot initiative to temporarily ban GMOs in the area. What's happening on Maui?
That's right. A group of citizens are getting an initiative together. They need 8,500 signatures. That's 7% of the population of Maui County. They would then ask voters to have a moratorium placed on GMO crops and pesticides. If that happens, the county has to conduct an analysis of health and environmental impacts of GMO. And as you know, what Kauai and the Big Island did mm-hmm. with GMO, this issue is not going away. So, Laura, you're going to have to keep on saying GMO.
Yeah, it is burned into my brain. All right, thanks so much, Chad. Get back to it. I know you got a lot of work to do.
Chad Blair
Thank
is always
you.
Wide awake when he joins us every morning.
Because he just keeps going and going. Thanks, Chad. All right, you can find the complete stories we just discussed on civilbeat.com.